Hello students, hi to everyone. I am coming back to explain how to find the position of an element in the periodic table. Generally we have nearly 120 or 117, 118 elements, but it is every time it is a headache to find its position exactly in the periodic table. So to know the tricks of the element to find in the position, to point their position in the periodic table, here we want to know some terminology. What is the terminology required here? Student, number one is the electronic configuration, and number two is the group, period, block, and the differentiating electron. Students, who knows electronic configuration and what is called group, period, and block, and differentiating electron, it is better to understand. What is the electronic configuration? Distribution of electrons in the ground state atom is called electronic configuration, and vertical column of the periodic table is called group, horizontal row is called period, and block is, I will explain separately, and differentiating electron. What is called differentiating electron? Electron that finally enters an atom is called differentiating electron. What is the significance of this position, to find the position, to know the position? Suppose if you know the position exactly, what is the significance? Student, because of this video, you will pick out the position of element in the periodic table exactly. And second one, because of this point, you will made easy to study periodic trends. Periodic trends plays a very important role total in organic chemistry. So it is a linked topic. So students want to study that periodic trends properly, the students want to know the position of elements exactly. For that I made some tricks here. Look at these tricks. Before to entering into the tricks, a small look on the outline of the periodic table. Students, in the periodic table we have four blocks. One is called S block, D block, P block, and F block. And before to enter into the tricks, here my first trick is, elements with atomic number 58 to 71 are called lanthanides, and these are belongs to, you remember, 3rd B group, F block, and 6th period. And the elements with atomic number 92-103 are called actinoids, they are belongs to 3rd B, F block, and 7th period. Right? And come back to, how can we predict the shortcuts? What are the shortcuts? Students, for any element, if you know the number of valency electrons, you will easily find out its group number. And if you know number of shells or valency shell number or number of shells, if you are known about the thing of the particular element, it illustrates, it reveals the period number. And differentiating electron. Differentiating electron means the electron that finally enters into an atom, that illustrates the block. Right? So, based on the valency electrons, how can you differentiate, how can you find out the position of group number? Students, for that, I will brief the some data here. Go with the data. Students, it is a one-year group. In the modern group, here mostless periodic table, this is the modern periodic table, this is the general electronic configuration, and this is the valency. Students, in the modern periodic table, in the mostless periodic table, it is a 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A, 0 group. And here the modern group, modern periodic table, these groups are assigned as 1, 2, 2 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Their general electronic configurations are NS1, NS2, NS2, NP1, NS2, NP2, NS2, NP3, NS2, NP4, NS2, NP5, NS2, NP6. Number of valency electrons are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 students. This is the information students have to required. And students, some more groups are there. In the mostless group, in the mostless periodic table, these group numbers are 3B, 4B, 5B, 6B, 7B, 8, 8, 8, 1B, 2B. But in the modern periodic table, these groups are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right? General electronic configuration of these groups are NS2 N minus 1 D1, NS2 N minus 1 D2, NS2 N minus 1 D3. Here some special notation is given. It is the abnormal configuration. Those abnormal configurations will be illustrated in a separate video. And you will come back to this group. That is the 1B group. This group also have the abnormal configuration. Here abnormal configuration means after NS2 N minus 1 D3 you are expecting NS2 N minus 1 D4, but exceptionally one electron is undergoes transition to N minus 1 D5. We will explain why it is NS2, this is the abnormal configuration. We will explain this concept in the stability of the species in a separate video. Until then you remember NS1 N minus 1 D5. And this is the valency electrons. Here S electrons are 2 and N minus 1 D electrons are 1. This is the distribution of electrons in the respective groups. Right? Now this is the time to enter into the how to find out the position of an element based on this data. Students, if you are liking my video, please share, please subscribe and please share to your circle. And come to the element number 1. Students, you take the sodium. What is the atomic number for sodium? It is 2011. So write its configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. This is the electronic configuration for sodium. Students, look at this. This is the first group, first period, second group, second shell, third shell. First shell has 2 electrons, second shell has 8 electrons, third shell has 1 electron. Right? Here how many shells are there? 3 shells. So sodium belongs to, based on the configuration, it is third period. And the general configuration, outermost configuration is 3s1. It is similar to ns1. So it belongs to which group? 1a group in the most place or first group, group 1, right? And differentiating electron, the electron that finally enters into the sublevel of the given element. Here the electron enters into S sublevel, so it belongs to S block. This is the way to find out the elements in the periodic table. I will go with the another example. Take a look. Taking atomic number 17. So chlorine 17. So write the configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. Student, in the first shell how many electrons? 2. In the second shell how many electrons? 8. In the third shell how many electrons? 7. So total number of shells are 3. So number of shells illustrates period number. So it belongs to third period. Right? And come back to the number of valency electrons. Number of valency electrons means number of electrons in the valency shell, outermost shell. It is similar to NS2 NP5. NS2 NP5 means it indicates group number. You will look at this table once again. NS2 NP5. NS2 NP5 is a group number 7, right? And so it belongs to 7th group. Or in the most place periodic table, it will be a 7a. Sorry students, it is the 17th group. It is the 17th group, right? And come back to the differentiating electron. Here differentiating electron enters into the P sublevel. So it belongs to P block. Right? Can I take one more example, students? Students, if you are watching my videos regularly, you will post your requirements as a comment in the comment box. All the positive or negative comments are invited. Students, here I am taking gallium. Its atomic number is 31. What is the configuration for gallium? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10, 4p1. This is the configuration. So you will write the distribution of electrons. In the first shell, how many electrons? 2 electrons. In the second shell, how many electrons? 8 electrons. Here 18 electrons. Here 3 electrons. Right? So based on the number of, here how many shells? 4 shells. So gallium belongs to 4th period. And based on the general configuration, it is NS2NP1. NS2NP1 is the configuration for which group? So take a look, NS2NP1, it is the 3 valency electrons, it is the 13th group and it is a 3A group. So it belongs to 13th group or 3A group. And here differentiating electron enters into which sublevel? 4P sublevel. So it belongs to P block. So simple to learn the students. So go like this, and I will take one more different example. Watch the video continuously. Taking scandium. What is the atomic number of scandium? 21 is equal to, how can you calculate? First you write the configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d1. Right? Taking the here D sublevel is incompletely filled. So first shell 2, second shell 8, third shell 9 and 4s is 2. So how many periods? 4 periods. So it belongs to 4th period. How many shells? 4 shells. So it belongs to 4th period. What is the configuration? Here configuration is 4s2, 3d1. It is like ns2, n-1, d1. This configuration is similar to, look at the table what I seen in the earlier. Wait for a second. So look at this. ns2, n-1, d1. It belongs to modern group 3 and the mostless group is 3rd B. So it belongs to 3rd B group or 3rd group. And the differentiating electron, that means the electron that finally enters into the, here is 3D. So this D block, it belongs to D block. Right, students? Here I want to illustrate one more best shortcut for the higher atomic numbers. Taking an element gadolinium 64. For writing the electronic configuration of such elements, it causes more difficult to the students and it is a time killing. But if you recall the starting part of our video, I clearly informed that the elements with the atomic number 58 to 71 are called lanthanoids and 90 to 103 are called actinoids. Here our element gadolinium is 64. It lies between these atomic numbers 58 to 71. All these elements belongs to 3rd B, F block and 6th period. So if you remember, 58 to 71 are lanthanoids and they belongs to 3rd B, F block and 6th period. No need to write the configuration. You will directly attempt its group number is 3rd B, or in the modern table it is a 3rd group and it belongs to 6th period and it belongs to a block. So no need to write the configuration. With this shortcut you will answer. And you take the 100th element. 100th element is the fermium. Its atomic number is 100. Don't worry, no need to write the configurations once again. So take a look. Here atomic number 92-103 called actinoids and 3rd B group, F block and 7th period. 3rd B group, F block and 7th period. Right? So only difference between the lanthanoids and actinoids is lanthanoids are belongs to 6th period, actinoids are belongs to 7th period. Come back to your example, fermium 100. So directly you will write its group number 3rd B and it is modern periodic table 3rd group and it is a 7th period. This is the only difference between lanthanide and actinoid and F block. Right, students? And in this video, I am leaving some examples, and you find out the answers with the help of this video, and share your answers in the comment box. Here I am giving the examples. Number 1, magnesium. In bracket, I am writing its atomic number 12, and I am giving aluminium. Z is equal to 13, and I am giving one more example, iron. Z is equal to 26, and zinc. Its atomic number is 30, and two more examples I will write here. Cerium, atomic number Z is equal to 58, and one more element, thorium, its atomic number Z is equal to 90. Right, students, this is the information. I thought this video is useful to remember all the elements position in the periodic table. And thank you for watching my videos. And students who are happy with my videos, please share and subscribe. Thank you for me. Thank you very much.